Okay, let me show you a very, very simple example on this. Right, so not sure whether you get back. Basically, I have a author, and Dinesh email something, an interest called MongoDB. Now, in MongoDB, this is the row. If you are talking in the relational world, this is the row. You have the column call name, another column call email. I have another user where I need information plus for some more. Now in relational world or relational data, what happens is you will include another two columns. Now in but including the other two columns means you are including that overhead to the other rows as well. But you might not update those data. Now in MongoDB, since this is going as key pair methodology, it is particular row. Now let's say I am adding another row or the collection document. Sorry. So it will be a name, email, interest, and let's say last name. Right. For that particular person, next person will have that information. Right. So because of that, you are not adding an overhead to the existing rows. Right. Now normally what happens is when you're adding a row, you have to, all the other key, the rows will be locked, right? So MongoDB is not the case. You are simply doing that. And so let me. Let me save this. Right, so I'm saving it, right? So I'm saving it to db.authors.save. And that author object will be saved. So likewise, I can add few more rows. Now, let me add the post also. Post. Right. So I have post now. So I have the title, author, blah blah, and an author. You can see I'm getting, and then these comments, right? Add multiple comments, and beauty about this one is you can add indexers to this level as well, right? So you can add indexers to this level. It's not only for the, I mean the leaf level, it's not the leaf level, the correct name, but you can add to that level for indexers as well. Right, so in case of searching and those kind of stuff, you can still go with the search. If you are, let's say you want to search by the all the blogs where people call Sushant has commented, so still the index will be used. Right, so let me, rather than going into all the details. Okay, so if you want to search something. It is post mean the collection, and then you can say simply find and title and what you want, right, or something like that. Now, let's say you want to find all the posts which has the comments, which has the comment name equal to the Preeti. Still, you can do that. So basically, most of the commands that we use to run are available with the Mongo. It's not a very new thing, and where you don't have anything to. Thanks, Sunanta. It's not a very the entirely new thing where you have all the features of the other SQL in the MongoDB as well. So let me if you map the SQL statement and the MongoDB, so you can see basically all of the commands that is available with the SQL are available with the MongoDB as well. So I won't be going into each and every details. So not that, there are a few other things, where closer, sort by, update, delete, whatever, you name it. Right, so all are there. Yeah, don't know the timing. Fine. Yeah, so another thing is about the MongoDB is other features available. For replication, I mean, if you are familiar with the database technologies, it's called replication, right? So in MongoDB, you have that under name call replica set, right? Also sharding. Sharding, okay, I mean, it's some kind of a mirroring, right? Some the partitioning, some kind of a part. It is not exactly partitioning, but it's somewhat partitioning. So it is there in the MongoDB as well, right? So if you are running, I mean, if you are working for large data sets, so you can have the sharding. And so stored JavaScript, if you are familiar with packages in Oracle or procedures in SQL Server, okay, again, MongoDB, you have a thing called stored JavaScript, where you can have the scripts inside built into the MongoDB, and then you can execute those to access your data. And this is the good thing, you have the C# support. You can write your C# code to access the MongoDB, right? To access the MongoDB code, I mean, like accessing a normal database, right? So, so I was under the impression that my time is running out, so I was, right, so indexing. Now, indexing, you can add an index. You can add an index like this. If I want to add an index to this particular, let's say column, to a title, so I can add an index like this, right? So it's, I mean, you can add multiple indexes. You can add composite indexes. So one is for ascending. So, and also if you are familiar with getting the execution plans, I mean, execution plans are, let's say you are running a query, right? And that is slow. So if it is slow, then you need to find out why it is slow. Now, in MongoDB also, you have that feature. You can see why it is slow, right? Likewise, you can go get those details as well. Now, we have done a small SQL Server and MongoDB. So it's again, you can't replace SQL Server with MongoDB. The relational world and MongoDB world are two different, right? You have to find out exactly what is the required for a DB. Now, classic example is this issue, like, so let's say users, right? If you are dealing with different organizations, one organization's user properties are different from another organization, right? So one might require first name and email address, and that's all, right? So next organization might ask, okay, I need first name, last name, spouse name, right? So if you are using if you are using relational technologies, your problem is that you are adding a spouse name for all the all the rows, right? So which is totally unnecessary, right? So in MongoDB it is not that, right? For the required rows only you are adding that column. It's not the column. We call it attribute. We add that attribute for that particular the required rows only. So your storage is much less, right? Now is less, obviously your IOs and IO subsystem, the costs are also very less. Now when we implement this in relational, we use SQL Server and MongoDB. I can't exactly remember the exact comparisons. If I can remember correct, SQL Server took 9 milliseconds, 100,000 users, right? Yeah, for 100,000 users, SQL Server took 19 milliseconds. MongoDB took 2 seconds, right? I mean, I'm not saying it is super fast. 19 milliseconds, 2 milliseconds. So that is not to say that MongoDB is super fast. This is only one scenario we got to compare with MongoDB. That's only the place that we could implement MongoDB where we were using SQL Server for that particular to use that particular feature. So one thing is when you are using the issues can happen with MongoDB. Let's say we have a row and I have a name and something, and next row you want to insert name. You made a mistake and your column name is different. First one is name and name, second one is name. Right, we all do that. Now, if you do it in an Oracle or SQL Server in environment, it will directly say this is a wrong column, but not in MongoDB. It will accept it as a different attribute. right? So you have that freedom, but use it with care, right? So you have the every freedom, you can name your stuff and everything, but you have. Now, statement is not from us, it is from the people who developed this MongoDB, which is called Tengen. The company name is Tengen. Actually, it is their slogan. We give the freedom, but use it with care. Now, with that, I'm done. Any questions? You can call it XML database. It is, yeah, but the thing is, there is no, I mean, if you can map your object-oriented structure into the database. In that context, yes, it is an object-oriented the database. Yeah, that's the thing. But you can't have all the object, inheritance, those things will not be there. What I'm saying is you map your objects, the whole objects into your database. And we are doing normalization, but that is we are doing at a cost. Cost in the sense of the when you are reading it, we have to join multiple tables where we are incurring a cost. So MongoDB is to support, that's what I'm saying. You can't simply replace or relational into MongoDB. Now the case that I told you before is the case where you can implement MongoDB. When we are going to relational world, you have additional column stuff which is null, so which is basically unnecessary. So in MongoDB, you don't need to do that. Actually, their main target is performance. The performance, that's why they have joins. So they have removed all this stuff in the sake of the keeping the performance, distance performance is high.